Good afternoon. A very warm welcome to all of you. I'm Deepti Lahane from Fiber to Fashion, and I shall be presenting the webinar today. We at Fiber to Fashion hope that all of you are safe at all corners of the world from wherever you are watching this webinar. Fiber to Fashion, as you all know, is a knowledge media and B2B platform that has been catering to the textiles, apparel, and fashion industry for over two decades. Apart from the textiles and apparel sector, Fiber to Fashion also has its main spread in the technical textile sector, where it delivers latest insights and industry happenings from the non-woven and technical textiles industry through its platform, technicaltextiles.net. This is our first webinar for year 2021, where we'll be talking about the insights and opportunities in various sectors of the technical textiles industry. So let us begin with our today's session. . 2020 began as a usual year for the technical textile sector for the first quarter. And April onwards, we saw that the sector got busy in manufacturing and providing face masks, medical gowns, equipment, PPEs for medical community, frontline workers, and the general public. To contain the impending spread of the virus, all public events were cancelled and facilities temporarily stalled. Market forces came into picture with steep rise in prices of raw materials and face masks. Plants that were previously manufacturing apparel switched operations, and manufacturers invested in increasing their manufacturing capacity to produce masks, protective gowns, PPE kits, and so on. September onwards, we saw that with gradual unlocking procedures in various regions, the sector started to resume its normal activities and business came into focus once again. Today, during our webinar, we will have the following agenda. Initially, to understand technical textiles, what is the importance that we saw in the pandemic year 2020, how global trade got dominated by technical textiles, some recent technologies and inventions in the TT sector, what are the current trends, and of course, the opportunities in technical textiles in the coming decade. Technical textiles have recently been seen as the sunrise segment for the global industry due to improving economic conditions, technological advancements, so on. And there are very limited number of global, regional, and domestic players who are fragmented. If I talk about the year 2020, we could see the following summarization for the TT industry. One, of course, was the heightened demand for crucial products as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic. However, demand for other non-woven sections declined significantly, including products such as automobiles, furniture, carpets, and rugs. Also, commercial enterprises who were into building construction saw steep losses. Significant negative effect was also there on commercial wipes and industrial wipes section, as most of the people were working from home. Two good part of this pandemic that led to innovations in the TT industry was that we saw continued innovation in non-woven composition to create better performance and an effort to produce more sustainable products. If I look at the percentage share of various technical textile sectors in 2020, I can clearly see that it is being dominated by three major sectors: mobile tech, Indutech, and Pactech, with a share of 20%, 17%, and 14% respectively. Talking about the importance of technical textiles that we saw in 2020, we saw how suppliers rapidly adapted to high demand of crucial end products. That too, with the limitation of a recession economy. Thankfully, the gains in Meditech segment offset the losses that we saw in closed construction, commercial, and industrial applications, majorly because all manufacturing plants as well as industries were closed due to lockdowns. Non-woven manufacturers who previously were manufacturing into limited scale capacities expanded their capacities and invested in a lot of machinery to manufacture healthcare essentials. This also included garment manufacturers specifically from the Asia Pacific region, who were the prime garment manufacturers. So they shifted their production lines, altering the production lines and manufacturing non-wovens instead. When I talk about the non-woven fabric exports between 2016 to 2020, we'll see two distinct trends. The first one, if you look at China's CAGR and AAGR, you'll see that between 19 and 20, you have an annual average growth rate of 62.29%, which is significant for a pandemic year. So China not only dominates in the textiles and apparel segment, but also in the non-woven fabric export segment. Similarly, we would see that for Taiwan and Turkey also, they reported a significant higher AAGR as compared to a CAGR. So for Taiwan, it was 22.0%, while for Turkey, it was 18.33%. Meanwhile, Germany and Italy had a negative AAGR, even though these two countries are one of the top exporters of non-woven fabrics, primarily because they had a lot of domestic demand for the production of PPE and other masks and other related non-woven items. Similarly, if I look at the top importers of non-woven fabrics, again, South Korea dominated the imports. If you see clearly, there is a significant AAGR between 2019 and 2020 of 89% and a significant CAGR of 20%. So it will not be wrong to say that South Korea, United States, and China dominated the import top importers for non-woven fabric markets. If I talk about some recent technologies and inventions in technical textiles, we saw a large number of players investing heavily into machinery or technologies to make the segment more productive. BASF added PPA portfolio of Ultra and Mite Advanced. Pontis Engineering Specialized, which specializes in one-stop shop engineering solutions, was able to take the development to next level composite solutions for the e-mobility sector. Vacutech, who's a pioneer of highly efficient products for thermal insulation, and Hutchison collaborated to develop high performance, super efficient insulation solutions to improve thermal management of airplanes and electric vehicles. Piana Group, the 439-year-old textile company, which is also known for breakthrough chemical treatment innovations for fiber and non-woven textiles in automotive appliance and bedding markets, developed a new technology which protects any textile or porous surface against viruses and bacteria. Ortholite, the industry leader of branded high performance and comfort footwear solutions, developed a new thermal insole technology, setting a new standard in cold weather footwear production. The U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, has approved Living Guard's patented self-disinfecting textile, which is again a new acme in achieving a non-significant non-woven growth. The new textile is effective against gram-negative and gram-positive bacteria to the tune of 1 lakh times in 10 minutes. And Living Guard's self-disinfecting technology remains effective even after 30 industrial washes, making it useful across many industries. Similarly, Orlicon Non-Woven also installed a double beam meltdown plant. And with this, the East West Holland company can now supply non-wovens for producing surgical and FFP2 masks. So there were significant inventions and technologies that came into place during the COVID-19 pandemic pertaining to the textiles industry. Now, if I look at the trends in the technical textiles industry, of course, because of the pandemic year, we saw a significant fall in the FDI trends in 2020. FDI in China, where the early phases of the pandemic caused steep drops in capital expenditure, ended with an FDI increase of 4%. FDI in India rose by 13%, boosted by investments in the digital sector. However, FDI in ASEAN was down by 31%. Inflows, FDI inflows to US fell by 50%, while to EU fell by 66%. The good news was that 5,000 plus patents were registered for non-wovens between January 2020 to March 2021. Majority of them by 3M, Asahi, BASF, Dow Global Technology, and so on. Another interesting trend that we saw, which I also highlighted during our introduction, was the steep rise in raw material prices due to the market dynamics in place. So if I talk about polypropylene raffia value, we saw from January 20 to March 21, the prices went up from $972.39 USD per metric ton up till $1466.36 USD per metric ton. Of course, there were a lot of variations between May 20 to October 20, but since October 20, we have seen a significant rise in polypropylene raffia prices. Another important raw material, PSF 1.4 denier, which is for the Asia market, saw again a steep rise in between March 20 to November 20. The prices were more or less stable, but post November 20, we also saw a steep increase in prices for PSF 1.4 denier. The dissolving pulp softwood value for the European market saw more or less a stable trend up till October 20, but post that it has shown a steep increase in prices. Coming down to the opportunities in technical textiles in the coming decade, 2021-2030, we at Fiber to Fashion have projected that the global technical textiles market will grow from USD 168.89 billion in the year 2020 to USD 205.55 billion by 2026, growing at a CAGR of 3.32%. Of course, this growth is attributed to the increase in demand for non-woven products and solutions for medical, construction, hygiene, and filtration applications. If I look at amongst the 12 segments of the technical textiles industry, the key growing segments would be mobile tech, indutech, and build tech, which would be growing at a CAGR of 3.91%, 3.61%, and 3.49%. Of course, taking into account that vaccination will solve the purpose and we will not face the third or the fourth phase of COVID-19 pandemic. The Meditech segment is expected to grow at a CAGR of 3.21%. As an industry, it is expected that technical textiles will move towards offering low-cost, sustainable, and environmentally friendly non-woven based products, complementing the shift in trend to use of lightweight recycled material, like we have also seen in the conventional textiles and apparel industry. And nanotechnology among the end users who are engaged in the production of healthcare, hygiene, construction, automotive, geotextiles, and packaging products. If I look at the global picture for technical textiles, I can happily say that Asia Pacific will lead the technical textiles market by 2026 due to improved regional economy and expanding working population, extreme focus on R&D, rising domestic demand, and growing automobile, agriculture, medical, and construction industries. Now, if I look at the top 10 countries who will have the percentage share wise for technical textiles, I can see that again, it is dominated by China, followed by United States of America, India, Japan, Germany, South Korea, France, Brazil, Mexico, and United Kingdom. If I look at the shares for 2020 versus those for 2026, it is clear that China will be growing by 4.34%, which has a share of 23% in the overall technical textiles industry. However, the highest growth rate has been reported for India, which is 4.94%. Followed by Mexico, which is 4.58%, China, which is 4.34%, and Brazil, which is 4.04%. However, China, United States, and India would be the three biggest countries who would be contributing to the technical textiles market. So we saw how technical textiles is evolving fast and can offer substantial growth avenues for both existing as well as new players. To extend our support to this sector, Fiber to Fashion has recently launched its market information tool on technical textiles called TexPro for Technical Textiles. This provides an overview of the global non-woven and technical textile sector with market data and insights into the critical elements governing the growth of this sector. So when we talk about TexPro for technical textiles, it covers all the important aspects that are needed to keep a good track of the technical textiles industry. The first one, of course, would be raw material prices, which allows you to have daily price movements and updates from across the globe, including historical prices for products like cotton, polyester, nylon, polypropylene, polyethylene, PVC, updated on a daily basis. You have global export-import data, which provides a data and analysis of 100 plus HS codes updated on a monthly basis. You have information on tariff, which allows you to have tariff information of 100 plus HS codes updated on a monthly basis. Market size, some of which I have also used in our presentation today, gives you the global demand and consumption data by subsector at regional and country level. Important aspect of the technical textiles industry, the patents, gives you an idea of the active as well as in-process patents registered in the technical textiles industry across the globe, along with details, including drawings and full text for comparison updated on a weekly basis. And you have tenders, which allows you to expand your business opportunities, where you will get information on all active tenders across the globe by category, updated on a weekly basis. The question would be, how would you benefit out of this tool? Raw material prices would allow you to understand the varied pricing in different markets and restructure your sourcing strategy. EXIM allows you to understand new prospective markets for your products. Tariff again helps you compare duty structures and trade restrictions. Market statistics give you a forecast for market size numbers on various subsectors to plan your future strategies. Patents helps you to track patents from across the globe and their details to gauge your product against those standards. Tenders gives you ready access to all live global tenders and enhances your business opportunities, while news and articles keep you well informed with industry updates and latest trends in the market so that you are aware of smallest of activities taking place globally. We shall now watch a small video. Post that, I'll be happy to take up any questions from all of you. Thank you for your time. All right, so I have two questions. The first one being, since the roadmap mentioned was leading to sustainability, may I ask what are the new innovations in non-woven fabrics that can be best used for a bed linen business or company? I would request you to send me an email for the same because this requires an in-depth discussion. So you can send me an email on deepthi@fibertofashion.com. The second question I have is about how do you arrive at AAGR? What is the time period? So basically, we have taken into consideration 2016 to 20. And the CAGR growth has been calculated, but between the 2 years, an average annual growth rate is computed. So if I talk about 19-20, that is where China has reported the highest growth rate. Okay, I have another question which says that how can Fibre Fashion help a technology startup in a technical textile sector? Again, I would request you to please email me because this is a vast area of discussion. So it would be better if you're able to email me. We can have a detailed discussion of how Fibre Fashion can assist you for the same. Yes, you all will be receiving a copy of the slides that I have shown during my presentation. Okay, so I have also received a question from Mr. Mohit, which says that how to set up a new unit in the field of technical textiles, will it be profitable? So Mohit, this would be the best time to invest in technical textiles, I'd say. And you can separately get in touch with us because we can assist you do a project feasibility study for a section on TT, which would depend upon which machinery you should be using, what is the raw material involved, what are the profit margins. Mr. Shashank, I have received a question from your side regarding Naga motifs through fashion blending for developing cost-effective and sustainable attires. I'm not sure how technical textiles could be used for the same, but I'd be interested in knowing that what are the kind of products that you are producing so that if I find that these would be relevant or you could make use of TT raw materials for the same, I can definitely let you know. So another question I've received is polyester staple fiber better used for pillows in the future? Yes, I think it is currently being used as well as a blend, but going forward in the future, definitely it has high scope. Another question I've had is what would be the best choice between traditional textiles unit and technical textiles unit? That would entirely depend upon the target segment that you're looking at. So if you're looking at producing conventional garments, which are used clothing for daily wear purposes or for luxury purposes, it's a apparel industry that you should target. While if you're looking at serving the rising teething industry, you should be looking at manufacturing technical textiles. I'd say higher scope of growth as well as revenue is there in the TT sector, and India is expected to emerge as the largest producer. So this is the right time with the Indian government focus as well on the technical textile section. Any more questions, please? Okay, so someone has requested for sharing a centralized point to reach if you are doing any new concept for technical textiles. You can send an email to textpro@fibretofashion.com. We have been serving this industry and we'd be happy to assist you for the same. Okay, I have another question from Mr. Prateek, which says, what are the opportunities in hemp? Now, it's a very ambiguous question, I would say, because hemp has in a normal circumstance, it has a lot of opportunities, but many countries have banned the production of hemp. So limited availability would restrain the kind of usability which is there for hemp. That is the only limiting factor. However, a lot of brands and manufacturers are already moving towards using hemp as a production material. Prateek, regarding your question on what are the countries where we can export hemp apparel and accessories, you'll have to send us a separate email where we can list down the countries which allow hemp apparels. Okay, I've received a question from Swati Shri, which is how can we implement ERP software in technical textiles? That's a very subjective question, Swati. So I'm not sure whether I would be the right person to answer that question, but you can definitely send us an email and I can ask someone from my IT team to provide you some kind of assistance. All right, so I believe that is it. Thank you all for your time and patience today. If at all you require more details on the technical textile sector, you can always write us an email at textpro@fibretofashion.com or Deepti, that's DWPTI@fibretofashion.com, and we'll be happy to assist you. Thank you so much for your time today. Have a lovely day.